from mom and dad, but sticking two together. UK Open gewonnen. Er ist der UK Open Champion von 2019. The Esp, Nathan Aspinall. Achtelfinalgegner von Nathan Aspinall steht in der Weltrangliste so hoch, wie er noch nie stand. Er ist die aktuelle Nummer 3 hinter Michael van Gerwen und Rob Cross. Hat das European Tour Event von Hildesheim gewonnen. Es war sein erster Erfolg auf der European Tour. Er ist der World Grand Prix Champion von 2017 aus Nordirland. Super Chin, Daryl Gurney!
Touching warm, reaching out, touching me, touching.
Two of tonight's quarterfinals have been set up. The power scoring of Ian White and Jeffrey Desvarne has seen them tee up a tie this evening. And the sublime finishing of Steve Beaton and Darren Webster has just completed 3-ton-plus checkouts, including the 170, to knock out the number 2 seed Gerwin Price. Now, as we move into the other half of the draw, we've got a meeting between two major champions. It is the UK Open winner, Nathan Aspinall, against the Players' Champion, Daryl Gurney. And a former Players' Champion joins me, Chris Murphy, in the commentary box, Paul Nicholson. This is a match that we've been waiting for.
Yeah, very good indeed. And you can see two players right there who are playing with a smile. It's really great to see after Nathan yesterday said that he came through the hardest game he's ever played. And it's never easy to play against Max Hopp in Germany, but there's added pressure when you've got that major in the bank. And I think Nathan Aspinall is carrying this tag as a major champion phenomenally well. And he's just one guy that you really want to watch right now. Playing with confidence, playing with a smile, playing with measured aggression, and against Gurney, who can mix it with anybody right now, this could be really good.
It's interesting because both of these players have said in recent days that they feel that they're kind of second best to Michael van Gerwen at the moment. And it's quite an interesting thought that both of these players feel that. Aspinall said in terms of confidence, nobody's more confident than him right now. Apart from
ladies and gentlemen, first leg tear out of the throat first. Game on!
Daryl Gurney is the world number 3. He says that he thinks he can catch Rob Cross in the not-too-distant future, but that Michael van Gerwen was, I think he used the word, somewhere in the sunset in Barbados sipping on a cocktail. He lavished purple prose on the world number 1. Two ways to look at that they think that they can beat anyone, and Gurney has beaten Van Gerwen several times this season already, but they would be on a collision course with the Green Machine in the semi-finals were they to win this and then the next match. And is there a slight, element of being defeatist against him by singling him out, much like players used to do with Phil Taylor?
I think that's a great point, Murph. I really do, because they shouldn't really hold Michael in that sort of esteem in public. Maybe in secret you can say, yeah, he's the best player in the world, but do you know what? Send a message to the guys above you in the rankings. Send a message to your opponents saying, you know, let's take Nathan, for example. Why didn't he just say, I feel I'm the most confident player in the world right now, and just leave it there?
Yep.
Didn't have to say anything about Michael, because I personally can't see a more confident player in the world right now than Nathan Aspinall. Well, that's my call.
Who would have felt confident with that particular checkout?
98.
He's almost missed a 170 at the minute,
isn't he? He is, but he's missed a 170. And now Gurney has the chance to hoover up. But he's forgot to flick on the switch. Early break opportunity.
80. Nathan, you require 72.
These are the kind of things he's been polishing up. Single 16 again. The fat bit for the skinny tops.
32. That only requires 24.
Collective groan here at the Glass Palast in Sindelfingen. And Gurney is back game to pin tops at the first attempt.
Gurney, second leg, Nathan to throw first. Game on.
There's every chance this is going to go deep.
We mentioned Van Gerwen. He fell over the line against Brendan Dolan, winning a 26th consecutive last leg decider in the process. But Daryl Gurney also had to come through a last leg decider. In fact, he survived three darts in different legs to be dumped out by Derby yesterday.
When you survive a game like that, and you say to people, I survived three match darts, they automatically think that you've survived three at the same time. But when you break it down, like Chris Dolby did yesterday, where he had three match darts in three different legs, it's more believable.
90.
Because of the percentages in darts and those skinny bits on the outside and the small bullseye, it's difficult to hit with one dart under pressure every time. And maybe Chris wasn't under a massive amount of pressure. The pressure's off today as he's having a cackle with Ryan Seale. Probably about some Twitter action that Chris initiated this morning, which was rather amusing.
But 86.
Yeah, Chris will rue those shots, but overall the last 4 weeks have been successful for him, and he's in a great position to get to the match play for the first time, but he could have done more.
Well, if he doesn't, he might rue them even more, 90. Because he also could have been in the top 32 as well, couldn't he? But he's been dislodged by Geoffrey Desvannes.
He's been made to work very hard for the
100.
For the apples on 80. The tree, let's put it that way, 40. Because it's almost like someone keeps taking his arm away, but tops leg. For Nathan.
Nathan Aspinall.
And that's a better leg from him.
Third leg down to throw first. Game on.
Yeah, Desvannes has got himself in the top 32 in the world at the expense of Dolby, who hasn't been in the top 32. He was going to be there.
60.
But that's the complexity of the rankings sometimes.
Yeah, Daryl surviving those darts. He was 5-2 down in that match against Chris yesterday as well, so it was a hole that he had to dig himself out of. Aspinall has had rather more serene progress in this tournament by virtue of his own excellence. 103 average on Friday, 6-1 win against Kim Viljanen, and then that match that you mentioned against Holt where he managed to somehow mute the crowd.
Well, the Nathan Aspinall mute button.
One right on 40.
Yeah, he basically showed everybody else how to play Max Hopp in Germany, didn't he, yesterday?
Yeah, I still don't know how that happened. I know how he beat him. He beat him with brilliance, but how he celebrated big style and gave it to the crowd and they didn't give him it back, I still don't get that one. But maybe it's just the respectful people here in Sindelfingen at the home of the Euro Tour. There you get a nice view from the bottom left of the stage as to what the players look at.
Yeah, I was going to ask you if I'll do it in the next leg, actually, Paul, as we just see if Aspinall can complete a huge checkout. He can't, but maybe Gurney can.
83.
143.
Darrell, we require 143.
One of the hardest, if not the hardest, finish on the board. Very close.
91.
Maybe that's good enough.
Nathan, you require 78.
Should get one, might get two, will get two. Classy indeed from a form horse who's just gone 13-14, 27 darts to get himself a break and a lead.
The question was that the European Tour is obviously played at 13 different venues around Europe over the course of the season now, but the stage set, everything remains the same. Do you get a different feeling at each different venue, or does it feel familiar everywhere you go?
Feels very familiar. 100. I think the only place that it feels different is Gibraltar because of the temperature. You go from a warm practice room to a somewhat warm stage. But places like 34. This, really airy here. Reese is the same, because Reese is massive. And the practice facilities in Reese, for me, are probably the best on the Euro Tour.
Might seem a small thing, but the stages in major tournaments can be different sizes, different colours.
Correct. The European Championship back in 2009 for me was odd, because the walk-on involved a staircase 57. To the left-hand side. That I think there was a helter-skelter staircase as well. And you went into this very small stage, which was almost under a balcony. But this one, exactly the same everywhere we go. And the European Tour do a great job in making it the same everywhere we trundle across Europe. But consistency is good in that respect. And I think the players really appreciate that.
Darrell, you require 127.
Gurney might need to take this because Aspinall has just exhibited his prowess on that kind of finish. Double eight will do it for Darrell. And that is very, very classy indeed.
Fifth leg, Darrell to throw first. Game on.
You stay classy, Darrell Gurney.
Well, the thing is, Aspinall had just taken out 78 in the previous leg and was sitting on 74. A very, very doable outshot. And Gurney found two trebles and a double to break with 127 96. Shots.
Just going on what you were saying before about the stage, there's a, you know, we've been having the same colour of carpet and backdrop. We used to have, remember the blue? It was very Europe with the deep blue and the yellow map on it. They changed it to black, which is really easy on the eye when you're a dart player because you want to focus on the board. I'm a big fan of changing the colour now and again.
Is there one that you've disliked? I remember Minehead, often followed by the sponsors, had a big yellow stage.
That was awful.
I've been a little bit blinding.
Yeah, that was not pleasant. I'm all for, you know, vibrant colours, but from a visual perspective, that was 95. One that a lot of the players really didn't like.
Well, both of these players enjoyed recent trips to Minehead. Gurney winning the Players' Championships at the back end of 2018, and Aspinall with that 85. UK Open triumph.
Darrell, you require 170.
In March this year.
Probably look at the 18s of the ball now.
83.
Oh, he got a small three, so maybe that dart will invite Aspinall in to give himself a chance to break, but he needs that 60 and gets it.
Darrell, you require
hit that beautiful first dart.
Well, it's the second part and the third part of the previous checkout, but this time he can't find the treble 17. So it is the ball.
62.
Well, he gave himself this chance.
76.
It's up to him to take it. Safe 20. Safe 20.
58.
Just under on the double 18 shot.
25.
And Gurney's favourite to hold now.
Game Sean, the fifth
gets
leg.
There. 3-2 Gurney. The number four Nathan seed. Looks comfortable.
Yeah,
both guys are in now, aren't they?
Hasn't missed a dart at the outer ring yet. One at the bullseye. 40. The only blot on the copybook of finishing for Darrell Gurney in this match. And he's playing an opponent who's never beaten him before, but they have only met twice until today. Darrell Gurney finds a treble 20 thrice.
80. impressive.
Gurney's just hitting a little bit more at the minute. Nathan is spraying a few darts here and there, and Gurney's keeping that composure really well. And that has been the huge difference in his game for me in the last year or so. I think he learned a lot from last year's Premier League about the way that you feel when you go into the campaign at the start in February, and how you will feel mid-season, and how you will feel when it's over. That experience last year for me has made him as a player. He was very raw, 60. Very emotional, very out there when he won the Grand Prix, but by the time he won the Players' Championship, he was a vastly different player and a much better one.
I think what Daryl Gurney's managed to do, every dart player will tell you, and you will be able to
121.
Confirm this, is that from time to time you go into a zone, and the top players do it more than anyone else. But staying in the zone is something that Gurney seems to have mastered.
I think it's about finding the ingredients 81. Of getting you into the zone, and then replication. So I think one of the things that certain players struggle with when they go through a bad patch is figuring out what they were doing right.
Yeah, and actually trying to change something that doesn't need changing.
Yeah. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. And if it's broken, find out what it was that made it good.
Well, Aspinall might be broken here. If Gurney can bend the ball.
98.
Twice he's gone you require 57. To the button.
Yep.
And twice.
A little bit of wire DNA on that point there, that's for sure.
Top cent for 3-3. Double 10.
Game Sean, the six leg. Nathan
Aspinall. More proof of the confidence of Aspinall.
Throw first, game on.
Proper darting dust up this one, as we expected it to be.
One run on 40.
It's intriguing, isn't it? The next game, Yozza and Magini. Winner of that one will play the winner of this one.
100.
Yeah, Jamie Hughes has been producing some incredible statistics in his performances, but he might be starting to get the rewards for those performances. However, Mark Magini was very, very strong.
I think Suwachin is, isn't he sharing a room with Yozza this weekend?
Maybe the case, they are in the same management table.
And let's not forget, it's not about money. Sometimes these guys like having company.
Yeah, you've done that. Have you ever played the opponent that you've been sharing with? Or were you always one to keep your own space?
I'm pretty certain I played against Mark Webster when I was rooming with him once. I think I did the same with James Hubbard. And they were the two guys that I roomed with the most. But 8-8 for another 8-8 conversion after two big travels.
Well, it's the first time that he's missed a double except the bullseye, which he's failed to hit twice. But it doesn't matter what you miss, 16. It matters more now when you miss.
8-8 then for 4-3. He's looking sharp today, is Darryl.
Yeah, well, it hit when it did matter.
Yeah, first start stats are good for Darryl. He's up at near 35. 80. 36 and a bit for his second dart. His third dart is lower, but then again, you tend to find that. A collective average of 100. And Aspinall just not hitting the same heights as yesterday. 59. It can be a grueling weekend when you have to play Friday as well.
This is how good he is, though, Aspinall. This is B-game stuff from the Ass. He takes our tournament tally to 150 and his own personal tournament tally of maxes to 8.
151.
That's 5 in the event for Daryl Gurney, who had hit 2 before this afternoon. But again, it's the timing, isn't it? Aspinall had made himself think he was comfortable in this leg, and now Gurney's piled on the pressure, and look what it's done.
It's difficult. He can go bull here if he wants, or go for the 6. What 81. A dart that is. My word. That is a worldie.
Well, the bull would have left him the 170, but he's found himself on 160 after that incredible dart. But Gurney continues to tighten the squeeze on the ass.
Wouldn't want to be the thing he's squeezing. won't have any juice left. Not going to get the big shot out here, but he is going to leave a double in the best way possible. This will be world class if he can convert this 82. He might have to go double-double. Not his best attempt.
34.
Now Nathan can breathe,
Nathan, you require 32.
Get this, and then possibly strike in the next leg.
Game shot,
what a good game.
Nathan,
this is one of those professional games that even the current pros will clap their hands at because they want to see a good dust-up as well, Murph. Yeah, exactly the same on checkouts.
And it's exceptional. 4 out of 7.
100.
A couple of those darts missed at the bullseye by Gurney. Who is going to blink first?
I am fascinated by blinking when it comes to mid-throw. If you look at their eyes, no blink from Gurney at all. Whether they know they're doing it is a totally different thing. There are certain players who pride themselves on the fact that they don't blink, but then there are others who blink just the once 81. After every dart. It's all about the process and keeping everything the same. It's been a high quality encounter, this really has.
Yeah, well, there's a lot the same
57
in comparing these two players in the last 6 months or so, and indeed in this match.
Might need another. Gets another.
34.
He might go back to the 19s on that shot, that 146.
Well, having just hit the double 16 to restore parity after 8 legs,
100.
619s would avail him a dart at the same target.
4 treble 19s for double 16. Oh, blistering! Absolutely blistering! That's Rob Cross-esque, that is. The setup shot, the kill. Nathan Aspinall is lethal.
Is that the shot that effectively wins him the match and sends the number 4 seed the same way as the number 2 seed who's just gone out before him? Gerwyn Price beaten. Darryl Gurney could be about to suffer a knockout on the stage.
Gurney has not played badly. He really hasn't. Sometimes you don't mind being defeated when the other guy's played amazingly. He's not out of this yet, Gurney. But Aspinall, the timing sometimes of his shots and his setups.
Well, he's played better than he did yesterday against Chris Dobie. Yeah. Has found himself needing to perhaps rely on Lady Luck once again.
96.
Kept himself on Nathan's coattails, but Aspinall's certainly in control.
Oh, he is now after that dot. He will be distraught with a ton after that first dot. He couldn't have walked to the board and placed it any better.
Well, Darryl needs 2 trebles. To leave a checkout.
100. Nathan, you require 161.
Invitation accepted by Nathan. 6 darts and 161. Gets rid of the 1. Gets rid of 60 more. And leaves himself on top. 20. And that makes that 1 look genius.
He knew exactly what he was doing, Paul.
Well, surely there's not going to be any more match darts 15. Missed against Gurney. Nathan, it's looking very good for Nathan Aspinall to go through.
Double top to finish the job. And book his place in the quarterfinals once again. A very, very impressive display from this very, very impressive player. A major champion and looking $1 million right now. Nathan Aspinall moves in to the quarterfinals and will take on the winner of our next match between Jamie Hughes and Mark Magini. Darryl Gurney, the world number 3, is out.
Starker Auftritt von Nathan Aspinall. Bezwingt die Nummer 3 der Welt. Darryl Gurney zieht damit also in das Viertelfinale ein und zeigt, dass man ihm auf dem Zettel haben muss. Applaus für Super Chin, Daryl Gurney. Schön, dass er hier in Sindelfingen am Start war. Congratulations. First win against Daryl.
Yeah, good mate of mine, Daryl. He's a great guy. You know what I mean? He's such a quality player, you know, world number three, you know what I mean? And that 1-4-6, God, where I pulled that from, I don't know, but.
That was amazing. I mean, and that's a situation 4-4. The shot of the game?
Shot of the tournament for me. You know, that's what won me the game, you know. I've never beat him, like I say, and, you know, that was nice. I never beat Max until last night, so, you know, hopefully, you know, I keep going and beating these players that I've not beat before, and, you know, hopefully I can win the title at the end.
Yeah. What are you going to do now? What's the time? It's 3:30. Are you going to go back to the hotel, or do you stay here?
Yeah, I'm gonna give my kids a call and the missus and have an hour's chill and then have a shower, have a bite to eat and then back here and, you know, hopefully have a good night.
Cool. See you later. Thank you very much. Nathan Aspinall. Sagt, mal sehen, was hier geht. Hat zum ersten Mal Max Hopp gestern geschlagen, hat jetzt zum ersten Mal Daryl Gurney bezwungen, freut sich auf den Abend, wird jetzt nochmal kurz zurück ins Hotel gehen.